Well, now you come to ask, no. According to most of my friends, I'm distinctly not normal. But when it comes to medical matters, thankfully, back I go in that safe, normal box. My cholesterol is fine. I'm not abnormally sad or happy. I'm way taller than most, but I contend that's only been a problem for short men. And as for my weight, well, we'll hear about that in a moment. But overall, I think I'm pretty normal. I thought I'd better check, so I asked.
Turn around, ducky. You look normal from the back. What do you think, Margaret?
You're in good proportion, I think.
So I have to ask you, sir, do you think I look normal?
Absolutely delightful. You're wearing nice normal outfit. Your hair's nice. You've got shades on. You haven't got tattoos on your face. You got a nice smile. Your teeth are good. Normal gorgeous.
Well, that's a relief. And no money changed hands either. Now, we rejoice in our individuality, but when it comes to our health, we definitely don't want to stand out. We want to be normal. But who decides what's normal? Is normal changing? And is normal for Norwich the same as normal for Norwood, or even normal for Norway? In this series, I'll be looking at how doctors decide what's normal and what's not, and what it feels like to be outside the normal range. I'll be looking at heart health, mood, height, and in this, the first of the series, weight. Now, I have a second question to ask, which is, do you think I'm fat?
No, definitely not. Splendid. I'd like to be that shape myself.
Now, you see, now you're a skinny person.
No, I'm not. I've never been this heavy. I've got a broader ass than anybody.
Now, you all look skinny. You're skinny.
Not in the least. Size 16.
I'd say that size 14 or 16 is average. But doctors aren't interested in dress size. And anyway, what's a normal 14 when every shop's 14 is different? Medical definitions are based on body mass index, or BMI, a formula that relates weight to height. Not so long ago in the US, a BMI of 28, that's say 16 stone for a 6'4" man, wouldn't have raised an eyebrow. It was fine. But suddenly, the upper limit of what was considered a normal weight changed.
Literally overnight, something like 30 million people became defined as overweight, because there were about 30 million people who had BMIs between 25 and 27. So remember, the definition for overweight used to be 27.8 in men and 27.3 in women. And suddenly, this decision was made to change that definition in both men and women to 25.0.
Barbara Moore, president of Shape Up America.
I think it was problematic because there is an issue with labels, and people were not happy to be considered normal weight one day and then be considered overweight the next day.
In the end, they had little choice. The World Health Organization's definition of overweight triumphed over that of the American government, thanks in no small part to Philip James of the International Obesity Task Force.
The Americans wanted everybody to be classified as normal when they were much fatter. They wanted the measure to go up and up steadily every year as they got fatter. And I actually had to persuade the Secretary for Health and the head of the NIH and others in emergency telegrams that the American expert groups were not talking rubbish, and stayed on for the press conference because they were appalled, because you're right, suddenly millions of extra Americans now classified as in need of medical help.
Who defines normal?
Very embarrassing to say we do in expert committees. And we come to a judgment about what is good for the population. And then we try to work out how you interpret that for doctors, which is why we come up with this very crude classification.
The classifications may be crude, but the labels they generate are powerful and can be upsetting, as I found out when I visited a special exercise and nutrition programme for children and their parents. Hello. Now, what's your name?
Sam.
And how old are you?
11.
Now, if I looked at you, I would say that you don't look especially overweight. I think you look pretty normal.
I have lost quite a lot of weight. I did weigh nearly 8 stone, but now I'm nearly 6.
So hello, Sam's mum. He didn't actually look that overweight.
No, but the word obese, when, you know, you massively think, gross, overweight, and it is frightening. It's a bit hurtful as well to admit that your child does fall into that category of being obese. When to look at them, you think, no, they're not, they're just a bit overweight. At the end of the day, what is normal? Overweight, yes, but obese, it just seems such a really big, horrible word.
Obese is a medical word, and all it means is that your child's weight or adult's weight is at a point where it will cause them health problems in the future, statistically. So it's not a criticism, it's not a rude word, it's not meant to offend anyone. Obviously there is a certain stigma to the word obese, but it is just a medical definition, and it's not a subjective thing, it's an objective medical measurement.
That was dietitian Paul Sasher. The issue that doctors have with weight is nothing personal, nor a reflection of how good you'll look in swimwear. It's about the impact on your health. A healthy weight for height is currently thought to be a BMI of between 20 and 25. Anything more, and the doctor will tell you you're overweight and ought to do something about it. Over 30, and they'll tell you you're obese, and they often add the word clinically for added medical effect. Fat isn't a middle-aged spread issue any longer. It's children that the obesity experts are most worried about. Since the 1980s, British children have put on weight faster than almost any other country in the world, bar the US.
There are so many children out there that are walking around that are actually falling into that category, and nothing's been done about it. Their parents are looking at them and just think, oh, they're a bit overweight, but they're actually not. They're actually obese.
Labels like obese are no fun, particularly when you're only 10. But how else do you motivate people and governments to take action? If all obesity was about was rolls over the top of your jeans, no one would worry. But it's the link with diabetes that is so concerning. Type 2 diabetes is also called late-onset diabetes, specifically because it was typically seen in midlife. But it's now being diagnosed in children as young as 9. Professor Terry Wilkin from the Peninsula Medical School in Plymouth.
The first children with this disease were first diagnosed in the UK some 3 or 4 years ago, but now probably every paediatric clinic in the land has a type 2 diabetic. And this is the fastest growing chronic disorder in paediatric practice. And it means that this issue of diabetic, cardiovascular, stroke risk and so forth is now starting in children, whereas before it was something that you saw just in middle age. Now, if the life expectancy of an individual with type 2 diabetes is 40 years, and that may be generous in some instances, it'll mean that children who are developing this disorder in their teens or even preteens may not see their 50th birthday. That's why we're interested in what's happening in children.
In fact, obesity and diabetes are so closely linked that Terry Wilkin and others talk about diabesity. Faced with the spectre of millions of Britons chronically ill with diabetes in the future, we're relying heavily on BMI to tell us what's normal. But how reliable an indicator is it? Professor James of the International Obesity Task Force.
It's hopelessly crude on an individual basis. It's perfectly possible to be muscular and not fat with body mass indexes of 27 and 28. But the point about the BMI is it's a good alerting signal.
Super fit rugby players are obese by BMI measures. US President George Bush and that superb male specimen George Clooney have the same ugly label, as did another fine specimen of American manhood that I met.
In the United States, I'm considered obese, and I don't consider myself particularly fat.
So why do people think that you're overweight?
Oh, I don't think people do, but the charts do. The charts that you'll see in the medical clinics will list my height and weight, but it indicates me as obese. It's just a chart reading. Nobody's looked at me and told me I'm fat. You know, well, and if they, yeah, okay, some, my daughter.
But is that because you've got more muscle than fat?
And I think it's because I have bigger bones. I've got heavy bones, I think. You know what, you're laughing, see, there goes my argument. And you're thinking, no, you're fat.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.